Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over some top tips using Microsoft Forms. We're going to break these tips down into five different categories. Tips for using the Forms app, tips for creating a form, tips for creating a quiz, tips for responses, and tips for sharing. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So let's start with tips for the Forms application itself. Once I'm on the main screen of Microsoft Forms, I just wanted to show you a couple of the different options that you have. Across the top, you can see that you can quickly create a new form, a new quiz, or you can view some more templates. If I click on this link here for more templates, I can see a lot of different options that I could use to help me get started with creating a template for my survey or whatever other kind of questionnaire I might have. If I hit the back button, I can also see down here that I can quickly access any of my recent forms. I can pin a form, which means that the form will always show up in this pinned menu right here. So for now, if I click on pinned, I don't have anything there. But if I go back to recent and I click these three dots, I can go add to pinned. And then when I click on pinned, this form will always be there. And to remove that, I just click these three dots again and say removed from pinned. My other option I have on here is I can go to all my forms. And I can see all the forms that I have created within Microsoft Forms. I also wanted to show you this link up here for forms. If I click on that, I will always go back to the original home page where I started. Our next category of tips is going to be tips for creating a form or a survey within Microsoft Forms. So to start a new form, I'm going to click the new form option right here. And let's just put new survey. So let's look at some of the options that you have for here. If I go to add new and I go over here to the dropdown, I can insert a Likert. You've probably seen a Likert before. A Likert allows you to have several statements and options for each one of those statements. Usually you see it in the form like this. Instead of option 1 to option 5 across the top, it is strongly disagree to disagree, all the way up to the sliding scale of strongly agree. You can also create more options across the top by clicking this plus right here, and you can have another option. Sometimes you will see that as not applicable. And you can also put statements labeling each one of these rows that you strongly disagree with or strongly agree with. And that is called a Likert. Next, I can click on add new and look at this drop down here and create something called a net promoter score. And what this is the question you've probably seen on surveys, is how likely are you to recommend us to a friend? You can have something on the left that says not at all likely, represented by a 0, all the way to a 10, which is extremely likely. You can also change these labels to something else besides not at all likely or extremely likely. Another option you can do under add new is right here. You can go to a section. And say I would like to entitle this section recommend. And maybe I would like this section to appear in between my Likert and my net promoter. So if I click these three dots right here, I can go to move section. And I can move it up in between my section 1 and my section 2 and say done. And if I wanted to move this section back, I click here and hit the down arrow. And now I will have a section above and a section below. So what does a section do? Well, if I go up to preview, I can see that my first question appears on this page, and then I have that section break in between my second question, so I get this back button and this next button. So that's how you section off parts of your survey. Now if I hit the back button, our next tip is called adding branching. If I click here and I go to add new, let's say I go to a choice, and let's say, which drink do you prefer? Let's say option one is coffee and option two is tea. If I click these three buttons right here and I go to add branching, basically if my user picks coffee, I can have the user's next section have something to do with coffee by just selecting it in here in this dropdown. And then I could have another section that has to do with tea related questions, and I could just use the dropdown here and I could select the tea related part of the survey. My next tip is to show you how your users can use the immersive reader. If I go over here to preview and I click these three dots right here, I can go to enable immersive reader. And so now that I've enabled the immersive reader, anytime I hover my mouse over a question, you will see this book. And if I click on that, I would be taken to the immersive reader. And then if I click the play button, the survey will be read to my end user.
One question. Strongly disagree, disagree, neutral, agree, strongly agree, NA.
And the immersive reader also has a few settings that may be of interest to you. If you click up here under the text preferences, you can change the background color. You can increase the spacing or decrease that, and you can change the font as well. Also, if you click the reading preferences, you can translate to a different language. So say you wrote your survey in English, but you know that not all of your responders speak English. You could change this to, let's say, Spanish, and then also toggle the document on and go back to your immersive reader and hit play.
Uno, pregunta. Totalmente en desacuerdo, no estoy de acuerdo, neutral, de acuerdo, totalmente, de acuerdo, na.
So when the immersive reader reads the survey, it will now be in the language that you have selected. If I go back to edit my survey, and if I would like to print my form, I can go up to these three dots here, and I can go to print form, and my form will be formatted in a readable print format, to which I can print or save it as a PDF. And our final tip for forms is if I go up to these three dots and I go to settings, I can customize a thank you message right here for the very end of my survey. So if I just say, thanks for your time, and I go up here to preview, if I go through my survey, after I hit the submit button, you can see that my customized message appears right here. So those are the tips that we have for forms. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. Next, we're going to show you some tips that we have for quizzes. If I hit the back button and I go to forms and I click new quiz, and let's just call this today's quiz. If I go to add new and I hit text and I just say, how is your math? If I click these three dots over here, I can click math, and if I go to preview, you will see that I have a calculator that appears with my question so that the person who's taking your quiz does not have to hunt around for a calculator. If I go back, another tip that I have for quizzes is if I go up here to these three dots and I go to settings, I can click this option right here for shuffle questions so that my questions for one student will appear in different order than another student who has the same link to the same quiz. So if I go back to forms, I would now like to discuss some of the tips that we have for what to do with your responses. If I go down here to the new survey that I was working on earlier, and I go over here to responses, if I click these three dots right here and go to settings, I can set a start date and an end date for how much time people have to respond to the survey, and I also have the same thing for how much time people could have to finish their quiz. So this option is on both types of forms. So let's say I just wanted a 24-hour period. I could change this date right here and change this time to 12 noon as well. I can also click these three dots here and I can print a summary of my responses, which is laid out in a really user-friendly print layout. I can also go here to these three dots and go to settings. I can actually get an email notification of each response. And speaking of those results, I can also go over here to responses and click on these three dots. And I can share a summary link of all of the responses that I have received so far on this survey. So if I click that, There's a link right here that I can copy, and then I can paste this link into an email, and whoever receives this link can also see all of the responses to my survey, updated in real time. And finally, let's end with some tips for sharing. If I go up here to send, I can share this by just copying this link and sending it via email. I can also click this button to automatically email the link to my form. I can click this button to get a QR code and share it that way. I can click this button to get the code to embed it on a website, or I can click one of these buttons to share it on social media. So there's a lot of options for sharing the form that you've created. So hopefully those five groups of tips are really helpful for you and help you get started in using all that Microsoft Forms has to offer. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.